Hey YouTube, we're going to start another series in this video. This time we're going to be looking at HashiCorp's Packer product and how we can use it to make Vagrant box files where we can use those to run our labs with. So like I said, what we're going to be doing is making our Vagrant VirtualBox images. Our images are going to have a selection of tools that we use on a day-to-day basis when we're doing our labs, and at the end of it, we're going to be able to use those tools off of every one of these machines. And also to make sure that we're up to date with security, we're going to make sure that the OS is updated with all the patches that are available when we build the machine. Looking at the patches, we need to make sure that we patch these machines regularly so that we don't get caught out when we start putting stuff into production and we've got a machine that we were doing our dev work on that's 6 months old, but a lot of stuff has changed because machines in production are up to date with their patches. So by automating this process, we can make sure that our dev machines are always up to date as well. So we're going to need a couple things installed on our machines. These are GitSCM, VirtualBox, and Vagrant. And then we're also going to need to download Packer. We don't need to install Packer, because Packer is just a binary that we run. And we're also going to need to get an Ubuntu ISO. I'm going to use the 16.10 Ubuntu ISO. And if you want to follow along with these videos, you best use that as well, because each one of the ISOs has a different set of commands to get you to actually install them. It's even different for 16.04 and 16.10. So like I say, if you want to follow along, get 16.10, and by the end of the series you could probably do your own images, so you won't need to worry about just using Ubuntu 16.10. Use whatever you want when you know how to do it, and that's what we're going to focus on in these videos. The GitSCM install has a section where we need to make sure we select the appropriate option. You can see it on the screen now, and this will allow us to actually use Linux style tools in our command windows, which makes it a lot easier to navigate while we're in the command line interface. So I'm going to see you in the next video where we're going to take a look at Packer and get our first machine up and running.